Hello, friends. In today's lesson, we'll be looking at rolling. In the one of the lesson, I show you how to model this tank. Okay, so today we'll be looking at rolling. So if you zoom closely, you see this one is the primary one and this is the secondary. This one is welded to this. Okay, so this is what we'll be looking at today. Okay, so let's start. Go to the level 500. Okay, in the lesson I taught how to set levels. Okay, so I want to go do Control I just like this. Okay, so this 500 level, I will bring it out just like this. Okay, I'll bring it out like this, click on. Okay, if I do Control P, you will see that the grid is at 500 level, just like this. Okay, so I will do Control P again to go back to the planned, okay, view. So just like this. All right, so what I want to do now is I want to mark out where I'm going to have the primary ray. So I will go to Edit tab, and then I will select point. Okay, I will use at any position. Okay, and I will pick this place. I'll pick here to place my pawn there, just like this. Okay, so after which I will deselect, I will select the point and then right click, and then I will select move. I want to move the point some millimeters. Okay, so I click here, I move my hand this way just like this, and I want to move it at 10 millimeter inside. I click on enter just like this. Okay, so after which the next thing I will do, I'll come to this place and then I'll tie my views vertical. I'm having two views, you can see the view one 3D. Okay, 3D 2 and view 2, I'm having it at 5000 level. So I will click on this tie vertical. So once I tie vertical, I will have two viewports. Okay, two viewports, and this viewport is the 3D, this one, and this one is the 5000 level. Okay, so I will go to steel just like this, and then I pick the columns. Okay, once I pick columns, this is the column parameters. Okay, so I want to place a column here. Okay, place it here. So once I place it, you can see it in this view, it cut across the height of the tank. Okay, but that is not an issue. So you deselect the command, select the column again. All right, so we want to edit this column properties. Alright, so at first we want to check the top constraint. I want the top constraint to be 5700, and then the bottom constraint to be 5000, just like this. That is, it's going to start from 5000, and then it's only 700. This 700 is the height, okay, above the 5000 level. So after which, click on modify. So once I click on modify, I will be having something of this kind. Okay, all right, so I will also select it just like this, and then I want to change the profile. Okay, the material, I will leave it to be x275. So I want to change the material. I click on this material. Okay, so in this material property dialog, I will scroll down, go to this circular hollow sections, and then I will click on this positive sign to have some other shape. Okay, so I click on tube. So this tube, I'm having it to be 200 diameter, 200 mm diameter, and then 10 mm thickness. So I want to change it to 50 mm diameter, and then I will change this place to 4 mm thickness. Okay, I click on applied. Okay, and then I come to this place, click on modify. So I will be having something of this kind. Okay, so this is what I am having. Okay, so what I want to do is, you can see the thing is a little bit away from the top of the tank, so I want to use it's already selected. I right click and then I'll move it. I want to move it a little bit inside. Okay, so I will click somewhere here and move my hand this way. Let me move it to 20 mm. Okay, so click on enter. I have something of this kind. All right, so I think I can take it in 5 mm. So I right click, I click on move. I will select this point and then I will say 5 mm, and then I move just like this. So I like it this way. Okay, so after which I will zoom this. I will zoom this out. Okay, all right, then I will be able to select this. I want to select this one, so I want to populate it from this point to this point. Okay, I want to populate it this one from this point to this point. So what I will do after I've selected it like this, right click, and then you click on the copy special and you go to rotate. Okay, all right, so in this rotate you have to clear this first. Okay, after clearing this, you pick at this center point. All right, once you pick at this center point, here we change this angle to 15 degrees. Okay, and then the number you wanted is, I want numbers to be 12, just like this. I click on copy. You see it's been populated. Okay, to up to this point at 180 degrees. Okay, so after which what I will now have to do is I will click on OK, and then I will of course I supposed to weigh this one to the tank. Okay, so if I undo this now, okay, and then I deselect and then come to this point, I will be able to use this one, this weight, click on it, click on this one, and then you click on the tank. It's now weighted. This is the weighting sign. Okay, so after which I will now go to carry out populating it along this axis. Okay, by deselecting it, select it here, right click, and then click on copy, rotate. Okay, just like this, and then I'll clear this. Okay, and pick point. I pick point. Okay, after I pick that point, I'll come to the angle in this dialog. Okay, this angle I will change it to 15 degrees, and then I'll have a 12 number of this, and then click on copy, so it will be populated. Okay, look at it. This is the wedding sign we are seeing. Okay, so after which I will come to this point, I will rotate it this way, and then I want to add a primary the secondary railing. Okay, so I will use beam. Okay, then I'll pick this point and this point to insert the beam. Okay, so I will be having something of this kind. Okay, originally if you pick this point, pick this beam, and you are having this shape of beam, you can just edit it the way I edited the column. Okay, you give it a section like this one. If you check this one, the section is 30 by 3, the tube is 30 mm diameter by 3 thickness. Okay, you just come to this profile edit, just as I edited this the column. Okay, so after which you will be having something like this. So if you notice that you see the, it pierces through the, this primary railing pierces through the secondary. Sorry, the secondary pass through the primary. This one is the primary, this is the secondary, okay? So what we need to do is we have to weld it to this one so that it will not look like this. Okay, so for us to be able to do that, we will go to this place, go to this place, and then we'll use this one. Say the tube saddle, if you double click it, you will notice that it has some properties, parameters, welding, okay? So you can see the welding type, you can select any welding type you want here, okay? So we'll be using this one, click on apply that, okay? Alright, so if you select the primary, okay, and then pick on the secondary, you notice that it's being welded. Look at the welding sign, and then it's being trimmed, okay, to lap, okay? So just like this, you do the same thing here, and then yeah, you have it welded like this, okay? So after which I want to send this down to another layout, okay? So I click on it, right click, and then click on copy special linear, okay? At this time I want to clear this. I'm going in the direction Z, which is the vertical direction, okay? So I want to send it down at minus 345, just like this. Click, then I will have it here, just like that, okay? So if I click on okay now, all right, so the next thing is I want to populate this to along this axis, okay? I want to populate this along this axis, just where this primary rail stand has been placed, okay? So what I will have to do is I will just hold my control key, okay? I deselect the command at first, I disable the command. This top one is being selected already. I hold my command key, select this one, okay? So once I select this one, what I will now do is I will right click and then click on copy special rotate, okay? Just like this, this one rotate, I click on it. All right, so I will just clear the system to have 0 0 points, so I'll be able to pick the center point, center of rotation. I picked it, okay? So once I pick the center of rotations, all the origin axis and coordinate will be fixed in the copy rotate dialog. So I will just change the angle to 15 degrees, just like this. How many do I want? Let me first say I want 6 of this, okay? So I click on copy. All right, if I click on copy, you have this, okay? Look at what you have. You have 1 2 3 4 5 6, okay? So if you count the spacing, you need to place this. You have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11, okay? So you have 11 spaces, okay? So you, what you need to do is to undo this one. You undo this one and you come to this point and change it to 11. Mind you, this G direction I will be 0, okay? So you click on copy. So once you click on copy, you will notice that it's been populated along this axis, okay, up to this point, okay? All right, so after which click on okay. All right, just like this, and then you deselect the command, click on okay. So we want to mirror this to this side, okay, so that it can also be in a circular path, okay? So I want to select all of this one, okay? If you zoom in, you will notice that weighted, okay? They are all weighted accurately, okay? So I want to select all of this so as to mirror it. So I'll keep it in this position, so I can see it very well. Alright, so I click somewhere here to draw a box to highlight all of this, just like this, just like this. So all of that is highlighted, okay? So let me check so I can note the one that is not highlighted by turning it, okay, to check the ones that is not highlighted, okay? So after checking it, I notice all is being highlighted, okay? All right, so what are we do now is I will right click and go to copy special and mirror. Okay, this one, I click on this mirror, and then we have to clear the box, okay, to have 0.0 points, so I can't pick the start point, my start point of mirror. So I will pick this point to be my start point. Okay, this point, I pick this point to be my start point. Okay, if I zoom in, let me see where I actually picked. Okay, I will clear this again. Okay, and pick this point, this one, pick this point to be my start point. So the second point I want to pick, okay, I will zoom it out, then zoom this point in, okay, like this, be able to pick this point. As soon as I pick this point, okay, I will now click on copy. Okay, I will click on copy, this one. So once I click on this, it will be populated. Okay, so they are asking me if I should keep duplicate. I will say delete duplicate. Okay, so it's been populated along this circular path, okay, to form a complex circular array. So I click on okay. Yeah, okay, so this is what we be having. Okay, you'll be having something of this kind. Okay, so if you check here, you notice that this place is not linked to this point, and also here too is not linked to this, because this one and this one was not selected. Okay, but that is not a problem. I will show you how to fix that problem. Okay, so I will first of all deselect this. I will select this one now. Okay, just like this, right click, and then I will click on, I will select copy special rotate. Okay, at this point it is the same this same origin and references. So at this point I'm having one and two, only two spaces to cover. So I will click on this point and select two like this, click on copy, so I will have it like this. Okay, all right, you will notice that due to how I selected this point is also not in touch. I'm having two poles here, two poles I'm having here, the secondary poles, the primary post two, one and two. Okay, so that is not an issue. Okay, so I will click on okay here, yeah, and then deselect this command. Okay, I will select this one, I will select this one, and then hold my control key, select this one as well, right click, and then I will delete this two. Okay, so I want to join this secondary railing to this one. So I'll click on beam just like this, and then I will zoom, be able to select the top of this. Okay, be able to select the top of this, and then select this one to have this. Okay, so if you notice that this one is not being welded and trimmed, so I will use this, click on this, click on the primary pole, and then the secondary to have it in place. It's been now welded and shaped. Okay, so you do the same thing here. Okay, click on this one and then on this one, all right, to have that. Okay, so it's now being trimmed. Okay, so the next thing I will do, I will click on this. Okay, right click, then copy special. Okay, linear, I click, and then I'm already having this input, so I will be working with this because this is what I used previously. Okay, so click on copy to have this here. Okay, click on okay. All right, so the welding and the trimming, you can see they are very intact. Okay, they are very intact and okay. All right, so this is how you can't be able to this is how you cannot close this now, because I don't have the any use. Okay, for now, for this one, I close this, and then I will come to this point and then type the vertical so as to see it in a full screen like this. So this endpoint are well placed successfully. So I want to remove this wedding symbols, this one. Okay, so I want to click and then click on this white background, right click and then click on redraw. Okay, so once you click on redraw, all the wedding symbols will be removed. Okay, so if you also, if the wedding symbol is not removed, click on this right click and click on property. So once you click on property, come to this visibilities of object type display and then click on it. So you check, if you notice wedding, this place wedding words, this box is not checked and also this box is not checked. But if you check this box, check this box and then click on modify, apply, okay, you notice that those wedding signs will come back again. Okay, you'll be seeing them on the design. Okay, but if you don't want to see them, it's quickly go to this point, uncheck this point, uncheck this point, click on modify, apply, and okay, and then modify, apply, and okay. So they are no longer on the model. So this is how you can't be able to model a railing on top of a circular top of circular tank. I believe this lesson must have helped you one way or the other. Okay, stay tuned by subscribing. Bye for now.